Hi everyone. I'm back to video three, and I've done a couple things to the painting, and I've let it dry. I added a little bit more blue because it was more green than it was blue, and I liked it better when it was more blue. So I added a little bit more turquoise and a little more dark blue. That's it. That's the only thing I did. And so it stands where it was yesterday. That way it's more blue than green. Now, I am going to start again with markers by marking it up. And I'm going to use various things. This is a regular marker. Again, not thinking. Marker. This is a Stabilo pencil. It's a water-soluble pencil. It's real thin though, because I want different size lines, thin and thick, light and dark. Now most of these marks will get covered up, but some of them will show, and that will give me the history that I want. Now these are interesting. This is a Listo marking pencil, and they are wax based, just like the grease pencils, except what I like about them, you can buy a box of many, many different colors, as you can see, and black and white, and you don't have to pull that paper off, because I seem to have difficulty in doing that, getting it to work. This way you just push the button and it comes out. I really like these. Again, it's Listo marking pencil. Got them off of Amazon. This is a white one. This is a Liquid X paint marker. That gives me a nice thick line. This is a Faber-Castell Pitt marker, but that's not really showing up. I thought it was yellow, but it's coming up more green than anything. I'll put a little bit in there. Here's another Liquitex marker. I get these at my local craft store. Do some red. Because today I'm going to do my warm colors on top of the blue. So. One thing I do need is some black paint. I forgot to get black paint out. And my white and black, I use the Blick acrylic, and I get them in the I guess it's a half gallon size, and it's very, very reasonable. Sometimes I use white gesso as well, but this is even cheaper. And the black and the white, I use a lot of it, and I keep gallons of it. want to put some black lines into it yet as well, so that's what I get my black out for. And I think I'm going to use some thinner black lines as opposed to the real thick ones. I'm going to get ready to go into it now with color. And again, I'm going to try to avoid the black so I don't contaminate it. I could dry it quick, but I'm not going to. If it starts to contaminate, I might dry it just a little bit. Remember to get my sides. You know, I almost never do sides. I usually paint my sides because I forget to do them. And it turns out just as well. But I thought, oh well, I'm going to challenge myself and try to do something just a little bit different. So that's what I'm doing. Okay. I am not going to drip right now. Now I'm going to go into it with color. And I'm going to use the same brush that I used last time. The brushes that I really like, that I use a lot of, are these Catalyst Princeton. The poly-tip bristles. I really like them because they hold a lot of paint and they hold the shape. And I have them in many different sizes, but I am going to start out with something just a little bit bigger. And as I said, I am going to do some warm colors today. We'll see what happens. This brush has some blue in it, so I have to wash it out. Okay, that should do it. I'm going to try to avoid as much of the black as I can. And this is Brilliant Magenta by Atelier. It's an open paint, which I do enjoy. Try not to think. And for those of you who have taken classes from me, you'll soon realize that I'm starting this painting much differently than I normally start. This is just one of the ways that I start. So now I'm going to put some white into that to make some pink. Isn't that pretty? Wow. Thank you. can see how I hold my brush. I usually hold it back here, or I'll paint sideways. I don't go like this usually. I usually work with it sideways. I'm not easy on my brushes. Should be, but I'm not. Okay. Now, as you can see, this magenta color is leading you all around the painting. That's my goal. So let's try another color. Let's go into the oranges. Wow. Woo! Put some white into that, see what happens, just to soften that up a little bit. A little in your face. Oh, I like that better. Okay, let's go back over it with this color. Let's with white into it. Look at this beautiful area right here. Mm. Like it. And again, the orange is leading you around. A little bit right in through here. Okay, now this color is cat red, medium. Some of my spots, now I'm starting to think, and I don't want to do that. I want to have some large areas of one color. Some large areas and then some small areas of the same color. So the sizes are different. I might have to go back in with the orange and do a little bit more of that. This is that same red with white in it. It's kind of a dull color. I don't know if I like that or not. This is pearl red, and I don't know if I'm saying that right. To it with, this is an Atelier color. I don't know how to pronounce that. Arlamide Yellow Deep, which is a lighter orange. That's interesting. I think I'm going to put some orange with that. See if we can get a nice coral color and some white. Ah, yes, that's pretty. I don't want to cover of all the blue. I want some of the blue to show. Wild and crazy.
Sure.
Wild and crazy. Okay, now this is golden Indian yellow, which is very close to that color, I think. I'm going to put some white to that, see what we end up with. There, when you put white into Indian yellow, it becomes a beautiful yellow shade. I like that. Again, I'm still trying not to think too much. Using the larger shape of it. I'm going to step back and take another look at it. Wow, that is wild. Wild, wild, wild. Now, I'm starting to think again. I think I want to go back in with my magenta and my pink and coral. And some more red. Is that wild? wild and crazy enough for you guys?
Wow.
Maybe some white. Lighten it up a little bit. And to lead your eye. See, I do my brush in many different directions.
That'll give me some good movement.
This I don't like right here. Okay. Now I'm going to make some marks into it. I think I need just something right down here. Stuff going on.
Wow. Okay, I'm going to try to bring this together. Who knows what it's going to look like when it's finished.
But as I said, I don't know if this is going to be a horizontal or if it's going to be a vertical. I'm going to go into it, I'm going to spray it just a little bit to soften up the paint, and then I'm going to go into it with my color shapers and my skewer. And some of the paint will run, that's okay. Yeah, there we go. We got a few runs going there. That's good. Okay, I think I really like this yellow. All right, now I'm going to go into my color shapers, and this is another Catalyst Princeton. I really like their tools. You can go into a flat, the flat side, or the edge, and I usually go through it a lot of different. Here's my color shaper, which will give me different lines. Thank you very much for watching me do this. It's been a lot of fun. This is my first adventure with YouTube, so so many of my students have asked me to put YouTube videos up, so I thought, well, okay, I'm going to give it a shot. So we'll see what happens. Looking at this right here, I have to bring some of that pink over. I can see that already. So I'm going to bring some of that pink over into the blue area. Yeah, that's better. That's better. I needed to do that because it was nothing over there. And right here again. I'm big on bringing things out to the edge. I don't like things to be inside the canvas. I'm more about the edge of the canvas than I am anything. So my next video, I'm going to try to bring this, I'm going to start finishing and looking at composition and design and colors and eye flow and all shapes and lines and all of that stuff. So I hope to do that tomorrow. I'm not positive. I am demonstrating tomorrow night at here at the Millwork, so I'm going to be working on that project as well. But I do want to finish this up this weekend for sure. So there you are, and I thank you. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this off and just show you some close-ups of the piece as well. So it's going to jiggle. Wow. All I can say is wow. This is wild and crazy, as you can see. Wild and crazy. But I think it's gonna be okay. So there you have it. Thanks for watching, guys.